Zoralys?
I should say Zoralys or Zoralys. I suppose Zoralys in Spanish accent, Zoralys in Latin accent, is that right?
Yes, as you prefer, because if you are in Spain, you can say Zoralys, but if you are anywhere in another part of the world, you can say just Zoralys, like the Americans.
Okay, good. So, cool, regarding the language, how is the in Venezuela, or Venezuela? Usually people learn English there, like a good level, they have a good level?
Well, they learn English just, you know, from an eager age, and at college and schools and even university, all the careers involve, you know, the English signature. So, in Venezuela, most of people like to learn already English.
That's good. In Spain, we are getting there, but still a long way.
Yeah. You know, you don't take so serious as us.
And about Venezuela, well, you had to leave the country.
Yeah.
We all know the circumstances there. You had a good position in the non-profits, so how it was your... The moment you said, okay, it's time, I have to go, how was that?
Yeah, it's quite a difficult moment in my life because my country was, and it still is living a bad moment, a political, economical, and social crisis. So I decided to leave my country regarding the security of my family. And it was just a huge impact for me because I had a higher position in my country. So when I come to Spain, I had to, you know, start from zero. Mm-hmm. It was hard, but it was a good experience for me to know myself and, you know, do things that I never have done before. And I am happy, I'm not regret for my decision.
Mm-hmm. And how are you finding, well, first, from the Venezuela Latin culture to Spain, the different the different culture, and now also the UK. How are you finding the three different cultures?
Okay, that's the most amazing and exciting things that I have experienced and when I decided to leave my country, because I thought that Spain is going to be more different than Venezuela, and it's not. Then there's some difference, you know, the times of for eating and stuff, but the culture is almost the same warmth, people, kind people, and I feel very, very, very comfortable in Spain. So here in the UK, it's a little bit different, because it's, you know, a society more, you know, more straight and, you know, properly behave.
More strict.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Could be. And but it's interesting too. It's a society from you can learn. And I am enjoying the experience also.
Mm-hmm. Good. Yeah, I think there is a little of difference between the Latin culture and Spain, but less and less with the time, because when the economy was good in Spain, many people from Latin America came to Spain, and then, you know, we interchanged the culture.
Of course.
So now we are closer to each other. Good. And yeah, with the British culture it's a little more different, yes.
Of course.
About the position. So tell us about what was exactly your role, how do you do, and now also with the International Amnesty,
okay,
with the non-profits and human rights.
Well, in Venezuela, I was working in an NGO for human rights, and that work with victims of a big crisis, in a political crisis in the 1989. That was a social crisis that left many people dead by the government you know, police and security on security forces. So the families of the victims founded this organization, and they just joined to you know, look for justice. Then from 1989 to until now, they are still working on that. I was part of that team during 14 years, helping them to, you know, to find grants and present proposals to many donors, and, you know, all the financing and stuff that allows the organization works in human rights, because cannot receive funds from the government, of course. So my job was mainly fundraising for that organization. Then in Spain, when I came to Spain, the first thing that I thought of was I have to find a new organization where I can work in the same way. So I found Amnesty, so it's my new home now. I'm working there with interinstitutional relations and with fundraising also. It's an international organization, as you know. It's working for human rights for everybody, everywhere. So I'm very happy to work there.
So the type of job in Latin America and in Spain in this type of organization, even, let's say, in Europe, do you think is similar?
I think it's different. For example, in Venezuela, with non-profit organizations, they can receive funds for other governments, for mm-hmm. example, because other governments are supporting democracy processes in America Latina, Latin America, or other countries in development. But in Spain, it's different. In Spain, you an organization that receives funds for a government or an international organization can be labeled like, you know, that has a political support, that supports some governments instead of people or interests of people. Then I found this big, big difference between fundraising in America, in Latin America, and in Spain.
Well, yeah, that is interesting. So how do you think you can contribute here in Hola People?
Okay, I have very high expectation with my contribution here in Hola People, because I think that I can improve the contacts and institutional contacts that a company like Hola People can have in the UK. And also, if there is any issue about fundraising or about administrative and finances, I think that I can help with any kind of activity that you need to achieve.
That sounds very good.
Yeah.
Now, what are your plans for the future? Once you go back to Spain, or what do you plan to do?
Yeah, my plans for the future include to go back to Spain, of course, and in you know, 5 to 10 years, come back to Venezuela and start my own consultancy company for NGOs, because my country is in a very difficult situation, in a humanitarian crisis that requires the work of people that is, you know, that is concerned about it and know how to work in Venezuela. And I think that I can do that job in the moment, in the right, when the right moment comes.
It would be great to keep in contact, and maybe we can collaborate
together. Of course, of course.
Thank you, Zoralys.
Thank you, Esteban.